We trust none but Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And I want to tell you that what you're doing is only increasing our hatred and the hatred of the entire world, Muslims and non-Muslims as well, to you, because you are terrorists. Your treachery has become everywhere in the news, killing the innocent people and the civilians, and mass destruction of communities after starving them to death. For years, this is your nature. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said that He opens all the doors of heaven and no barrier that stands between the dua of the oppressed one and Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Da'watul mazloom reaches directly to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, whereupon Allah responds saying, وَعِزَّتِي وَجَلَالِي لَأَنْصُرَنَّكِ وَلَوْ بَعْدَ حِينَ. Remember, we prayed against Sharon. Many of the scholars asked Allah to give him a long life, but to torture him in this life. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala responded, he's neither alive nor dead. And I ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to give your leaders the same fate. Your leaders and those who supported them from amongst the Muslims, to give them the same fate. And I ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to have mercy on the Muslim ummah. And I ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to render the ummah to the book of Allah and the sunnah of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. As far as our victims, as I said, we're not worried about them because they are in a better place right now. They're in heaven with the Lord being provided. We're only worried about ourselves. We're only worried about our reaction. We're only worried about giving an excuse before Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to pardon us for our shortcomings. I'm worried about the Muslim leaders. What are they going to say to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala tomorrow? Don't you know that tomorrow, the day after tomorrow, in a near period of time, two or three, one day you're going to die. No White House, no Congress, no one is going to support you against Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. You're going to stand all alone before Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to answer, why did you stop the aid from reaching your brothers and sisters? Why did you assist the enemies in their treachery, in attacking the innocent people? What are you going to say to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala? Have you prepared an answer for that? Have you prepared an answer for such question? I'm worried about you. Wallahi, I'm saying this sincerely from the bottom of my heart. Isn't it about time to feel the pulse of your own people? Of your own people whom you rule? Don't you know that Muslims should be united as a single body? As the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said in the hadith, مثل المؤمنين في توادهم وتراحمهم وتعاطفهم كمثل الجسد الواحد إذا اشتكى منه عضو تداعى له سائر الجسد بالحمى والسهر. This should be the case of the Muslim ummah, like a single body. If any member, if any body part is aching out of pain, the entire body is in pain as well. Many of us go to doctors suffering from ailments due to excessive eating and obesity. And our brothers and sisters in Gaza and in many other Muslim places are suffering out of hunger and thirst and lack of basic needs for the life, medication. Have mercy on them. Fear Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Oh Allah, I disassociate myself from their evil doing. Oh Allah, utilize us the way you wish. Oh Allah, give us the honor of the shahada for your sake. I call upon the entire ummah to do two things. You can give victory to your brothers and sisters, one by the dua, day and night. Ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to remove this cloud. Ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to give victory to the ummah, to unite us and to make us strong in iman. And the second, you can defeat the enemies by reading the Quran, by recognizing the nature of your enemies. By Allah, if you start reading the Quran and knowing the Sunnah, why did the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam kick them out of Al-Madinah? Studying the battle of Khaybar, Bani Qiniqa', Bani Nadir, and so forth. That is the biggest defeat to your enemies. When you return back to your deen, when you recognize whom you are, When the Muslim youth stop watching the video clips and sending SMS and wasting their money and their resources on evil activities. When you stop surfing the evil websites. When you start recognizing yourself. When you start preserving your identity. When you start sincerely while putting any bite into your mouth, thinking of your brothers and sisters. This ummah has no boundaries. This ummah does not recognize hudud. This ummah does not have any geographic boundaries or limits. It is a universal ummah. We care and we feel the suffering of every Muslim anywhere in the Muslim world. This is how it should be. We do not recognize Palestinians and Egyptians and Syrians as different people. We're all one single ummah. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said in Surah Al-Anbiya, إن هذه أمتكم أمة واحدة وأنا ربكم فاعبدون. Verily, this is your ummah, one single united ummah, and I am your Lord, so worship me alone. وفي سورة المؤمنون he said, وإن هذه أمتكم أمة واحدة وأنا ربكم فاتقون. And verily, this is your ummah, a single united ummah, and I am your Lord, so fear me. What made Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala repeat the same verse twice? Because of its importance. وَاعْتَصِمُوا بِحَبْلِ اللَّهِ جَمِيعًا وَلَا تَفَرَّقُوا. And hold you fast to the rope of Allah and do not be divided. The rope of Allah which stretched from heaven to earth, one of its end is with Allah and the other is extended to us to hold fast unto it. Is the Quran. If a Muslim sinner today vows to stop the sin and to start a new act of worship, this is how you give victory to your brothers and sisters.